Not once, not twice, but thrice in American history, the candidate with the most votes from the people actually lost because of the Electoral College. Three errors in 55 plus elections is a failure rate of 5%.
Is it time to look at changing the U.S. electoral system?
Don't hold back.
This is not democracy. This is indefensible.
Citizens of the United States do not vote directly for president. They vote for electors who then vote directly for president.
But, oh, hold on there, son, you might be saying to yourself right now. You're missing the whole point of the Electoral College. It's to protect the small states from the big states. Electoral College doesn't make candidates care about small states.
If voters are given fewer opportunities to judge the character of our candidates in person, I think that we will be poorer judges of character.
By making sure that some people's votes are more equal than others. Redistribution, the Electoral College essentially pretends that fewer people live where they do and more people live where they don't. I'm just the same as I was. Three errors in 55 plus elections is a failure rate of 5%.
So, is it time to look at changing the U.S. electoral system? It's time to
begin. Maybe switching to the national popular vote would open the door for more than two candidates to run. Maybe it would change the political calculus in new, unpredictable, but beautiful ways.
This kingdom shall fall.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your